If there's been a notable rivalry over just one issue, well, the signs point to property taxes. With Gord Steeves zeroing in on Judy Washalishalees and their differing opinions on raising taxes or keeping them right where they are. After an almost 14-year freeze on property taxes, the city, under Sam Cates, was forced to raise rates by more than 3%. Steeves has promised to return to frozen rates, warning that Winnipeg could become less competitive. Also, with a promise to leave taxes alone for her entire term, Paula Havixback says the city can count on receiving up to 14% more property tax year over year as homes are assessed at a higher value. She also promises to spearhead significant internal savings at City Hall. For some perspective on how property tax here compares with costs around the country, Winnipeg lays in the middle of the pack when stacked up against Canada's 10 largest cities, with the average household paying $3,347 a year. Paying the most are people living in Saskatoon, while the cheapest rates are in Vancouver.
Affordability means keeping taxes in the neighborhood of cost of living, including population growth. And by all accounts, that number is less than 3%.
Washalishalees and the remaining four candidates admit taxes may need to change. She feels the lack of property tax increases have been made at the expense of roads and city services. With one of the most expensive hikes, Michel Filion is ready to raise property taxes by 10% over 2 years. He says the funding will be focused on his massive road infrastructure program. Dave Sanders has been very loud about Winnipeg's tough financial situation, which he says will result in some serious shortcomings come budget time. He recommends a 5% tax increase, in which 2% will go directly to roads. But when it comes to taxation, property tax isn't the only way to pay the bills. Robert Falcon Ouellette says he's leaving a tax hike as a last resort. But before that, he's proposing a land value tax for downtown surface parking lots, a change that could encourage more development in the downtown while also raising over $26 million. Ouellette would also increase the environmental levy on drink containers, half of which would turn into a refundable deposit, the rest going towards environmental projects. And finally, we have Brian Bowman, who for now plans on tying a property tax increase to the rate of inflation. But down the road, he's also talking about getting rid of the property tax altogether. Bowman suggests that something like a municipal sales tax could be a new way of pulling in cash. So, to recap, when it comes to raising taxes, that's five candidates who say it must be done and two who are ready to freeze. For Breakfast Television, I'm Natalie Geddes.